Come gather round, children, it's high time he learns about a hero named Homer and a devil named Burns. We'll march till we drop, the girls and the fellas. We'll fight till the death or else fold like umbrellas. So we'll march day and night by the big cooling tower. They have the plant, but we have the power.
I thank the creator, merci à la créateur pour faire une autre opportunité pour tout le monde de vivre sur les mers du Caire. Thank you to the creator for giving us another day to live on beautiful Mother Earth. And thank you to Chokchok and Drums for their beautiful song for us this morning.
C'est une journée triste pour le Canada aujourd'hui parce que son gouvernement persiste et continue de s'entêter et continue de s'opposer à la Déclaration universelle sur les droits des peuples autochtones, sur les droits de nos peuples. La journée du 13 septembre prochain pourrait être une journée un peu plus heureuse. Et M. Harper, vous avez encore un certain temps pour revenir à la raison et voter en faveur de la déclaration. Façon de finir la semaine, une marche comme celle d'aujourd'hui, énergisante, mais on sait que c'est pas la fin. Que en dépit de ce qui peut arriver jeudi prochain, la lutte et la bataille des peuples autochtones au Canada va se poursuivre parce qu'il y a plus de 400 ans d'injustice à corriger.
Todos los indígenas, desde el Polo Norte hasta el Polo Sur, somos un solo pueblo.
Todos los autóctones del Polo Norte al Polo Sur, somos el mismo pueblo.
Un solo corazón.
Nous sommes un seul cœur.
Un solo sentimiento.
Un seul sentiment.
Un solo puño.
Un seul poignet de
Nuestra lucha es nuestra lucha.
Votre lutte est notre lutte. Canada is a hypocrite in its proponent as a proponent for human rights in this world. They are hypocrites in how they tell the rest of the world that they treat Indigenous people living in Canada. They are hypocrites in how they deal with us. In token legislation that supposedly gives us equal rights to the rest of civil society. We are distinct people who for over 500 years have been struggling to save our languages, our culture, and our systems of governance. Indigenous women, who are the most marginalized and most violated people on this planet as well, need the support of this declaration. If Canada continues to oppose this declaration, then it is shame on Canada, shame on New Zealand, shame on Australia, shame on the United States of America. We can no longer wait for our rights to be respected. We are not asking for more rights. We are asking, as Indigenous people of this beautiful Mother Earth, for equal rights, to be able to preserve our identity, to be able to preserve our lands and our territories for future generations. Canada's position now, this Conservative government, is economic development over human rights. And this has to stop. As long as the declaration is going to be undermined by countries like Canada, poverty will not be ended. As long as Canada continues to threaten countries like Kenya that they will cut off their aid if they vote in favor of the declaration, then there will be no equality and no justice for any Indigenous person and any person on this planet. So I urge you to tell your government to vote in favor of this declaration. Tell your government of Canada, tell your leaders at the National Assembly, as Françoise David has mentioned, to urge Canada to vote on this aspirational document that gives something to the most marginalized people on this planet, hope and equality of rights. Canada must vote yes. Canada must vote yes. Canada must vote yes. And it does my heart such happiness to see all of you here, because this is such an important event for Indigenous people, but it's an important event for people of all this world. So thank you all for coming here today, and let's keep putting pressure on Canada. Woo! Let's keep up the fight.